Hi everyone, this is Luke with Carlson Cash. Today we're going to run through the Cash Position app. This app is updated real time and is used to provide a high level view of your cash balances in SAP. This is our second video in our Rapid Cash Management series, and we'll continue to go over the rest of these cash management apps over the next few weeks. We thought this was a natural progression from our last video, which covered the intraday bank statement monitor, since now all of our bank statements have been successfully loaded into SAP, and we can start to look at our cash position for the day. In S4 Cash Management, there are two primary apps that can be used for cash positioning and forecasting. The first is the Cash Position app that we're covering today, which provides a very high-level dashboard-type view of cash activity. We also have another app, which is called the Cash Flow Analyzer. The Cash Flow Analyzer gives us that next level of detail into the activity that make up your cash balances. If you're familiar with SAP Treasury and ECC, the Cash Flow Analyzer is similar to FF7A and FF7B, whereas the Cash Position app is meant to provide a much higher level view of cash without getting into the individual line item detail. Okay, so let's get into our SAP system here. As you can see, we've got our Cash Position app displayed here, and it's displaying 52.9 million USD equivalent. So this is all of our cash position flows converted back to USD using the exchange rates we already have set up in our SAP system. So we can drill into this even further and see what this $52.9 million is made up of. So right now we have this organized by bank country. We have this broken out by our three different bank countries in which we hold cash. We can also make changes to this and view this by the different company codes we have set up in SAP. So these are our three main company codes. We can also view this by our banking partners. So we can view how we have cash distributed across our main banks. And we can also make changes to this. If we don't want to view this using a bar chart, we can come over here and make changes. And maybe we want to view this using a pie chart, or maybe we want to view this using a heat map. So we can make all these changes on the user side. We can also filter what data is flowing into the cash position by coming up here and making changes to this. So right now we're displaying this in USD using the M rate for the conversion. But if we want to make changes to this and filter what company codes we want displayed or what account numbers, we can easily do that up here. We can also take this data that we've filtered and make custom tiles based on how we want to view this data. So I created a few custom tiles here. And our first tile here, we have everything converted back to Euro. In the previous examples, everything was converted back to USD, but now this is a tile displaying the local equivalent in Euro. This next example here, we've got our cash position broken out by our main three company codes and how the cash is distributed upon those main three company codes. There's also a way to create different thresholds and different warnings based on how you want to set this up. So in this example here, I've got two tiles with different thresholds and different warnings. This first one here, I have it set up with a $60 million threshold. So anything under $60 million is going to give us a yellow status, letting us know that we need to come back to this, take a look at this cash position, and determine why it's sitting below our $60 million threshold. I also have another alert set up here where, in this example, let's say we've got a payroll account that we want to keep funded at $25 million. If it's sitting below that $25 million threshold, it's going to flash red, letting us know that it's sitting below our threshold, and we should take a look at this and determine why it's only at $15.4 million. As you can see, this app is super flexible, and it gives you a really nice summary of your cash position. I hope this video was helpful. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to reach out. Thanks.